Checking my headphone monitors. Ooh, looks a little loud. Check one, two. Check one,
Check
two.
one, two.
I'm gonna talk louder today. I'm gonna speak louder today. I'm gonna speak in my talking voice today. Excuse me. I'm gonna talk like this most of the time. Gotta turn off my headphones. Ah, crap. I think I need to mute my browser window. I'm forgetting to do this kind of stuff. Here we go. I gotta mute this, because if it comes on, it's gonna double up my voice, like, over and over again. Anyway. Hello, one viewer, which, if I'm right, this happens to be me watching myself on the browser window. Cool. Today, daily study group, our still life. This one's a little weird, guys. We're not going to be able to draw the same stuff, right? I mean, like, there's absolutely no way you're going to be able to draw what I'm drawing. Because we're doing a still life. And the past few ones, we've told you resources on where to go and what to do to get something going. So I've got, like, my GoPro camera and my scarf on my desk, and I got my desk lamp positioned in such a way that it's creating pleasing shadows. By pleasing shadows, I mean, like, I'm not killing the shadows with my light. I'm creating some dynamic shadows that can incorporate that in the painting of my still life today. I'm gonna switch around brushes. I'm not gonna use the marquee tool, lasso tool, yada yada yada. I'll use the brush tool and the undo button if I make a terrible mistake or Photoshop starts glitching on me. I'm gonna try and keep everything in one layer, and I'm just gonna work on this for an hour. I don't know what I'm gonna talk about. I mean, I'll talk about, like, what I'm drawing, I guess, but I'm not going to, you can't see what I'm drawing, so it's kind of like no way for me to effectively communicate what's going on without just saying, yep, I'm getting it right, or, like, I'm getting close to right, and you have to trust me. So, I wonder if my stream stopped. My time machine is trying to perpetually back up my computer every 30 minutes. So every 30 minutes, my connection gets really slow. I'm just going to double check one more time to make sure that I am, in fact, streaming, which I hope I'm streaming. If you're here and if you're in the chat and if you can see what I'm doing, let me know. Unless you don't give a shit, in which case, just, you know, don't worry about it, I guess. You'll just happen to listen to me talk over audio if the video's not playing. Because for some reason the video doesn't load on my computer. I don't know why now. Anyway, I got the chat open off to the side right here so I can see what you're saying. Let's start up a timer and get going on this. I've been playing around with this brush a lot. And it has, like, these nice, what I call, like, creamy transitions and textures. So I like it. I'm gonna probably use one of these. I don't know which one yet. And that's just because I'm choosing these brushes because I don't normally use them. So I'm trying to figure out if I want to spend an hour working with them. Because, maybe this one. It'd be good practice to, like, figure out how this thing operates for later on. This one's pretty cool. It's like a really dry brush or something. What's this one? Ah, this is the angled version of the one I had. It looks like it's 3D. Anyway, okay, I'm gonna get a timer started. We could probably get a conversation going if there's people actually watching. Well, actually, I guess you should be drawing, so. I was rewatching the Kemp Remillard Crimson Conversation, and I'm going to be watching that today while I work. Or I'm not really watching it so as much as I'm listening to it. But it's a really good one. Okay. Let me use this one. Get my timer started. I've got to do storyboards today, so I can't show anyone what I'm working on later. But I'm probably going to get burnt out on doing them all day, and then I'm going to come back on and sketch some ideas out for a new piece later tonight. But, I've lost track of what I was doing. Oh, here I am, turning on my timer. 1 hour timer. Like I said before, if you're joining me in the study, you gotta get a still life set up because today's a still life day. You can do whatever you want though, you don't have to do any of this stuff. But today's a still life day and there's no way for us to be able to. I don't want to take a photo, I want to work from life. That's the whole point of the still life. So, starting the timer. I kind of set ground rules for myself on every study, and if it's the first time you're joining me, then I'll quickly kind of tell you what my ground rules are. And those are, like, for the still life in particular, I'm not going to take a photo of it. I'm going to keep it set up in my room. I guess I could take a photo and show you what exactly I was drawing, but the thing is my camera is going to it's going to capture lighting that's different from the lighting I'm seeing with my eyes. Because the camera's not going to be as powerful as my eyes are in terms of the dynamic range. Your eyes are capable of seeing really light lights and really dark darks at the same time without having to adjust in the way a camera does. So you can look out your room and you can see that it's sunny outside, and if you have no lights on in your room will be really dark and your eyes aren't going to like blow out the whites or something. I mean, it happens when you walk outside for the first time and you've been inside all day. But generally speaking, you don't better dynamic range with your eyes. So anyway, I can show you a picture of what I'm drawing, but it's not going to be exactly the same in terms of the range of values and what they are. But I'm trying to block out the forms pretty fast. And because it's just a still life, all I'm focusing on is getting the lighting to match and getting the fabrics and materials to read. I say fabric because I have a scarf in here. So it's a scarf and a GoPro camera. So I got like hard surface next to some soft surface, a more organic curves with a very industrial manufactured object. And just blocking out the values before I get going. I've kind of been thinking about it. I'm thinking I'm going to be working on lots of anatomy coming up on the next 7 days. It's going to be 7 days of anatomy. And anatomy, like, specifically, like, looking at musculature in the body and drawing out how the muscles connect. So that I could kind of invent my characters and positions easier. So I have a slightly stronger grasp if there's just absolutely no way I can get reference, which doesn't really happen anymore. But if for some reason I couldn't get any reference, I could kind of build my own character with my knowledge of the anatomy. Which is something I haven't really done before, as I don't really study the anatomy in terms of like musculature on bone. I always study that kind of stuff in forms of like figure drawings. I'm practicing the figure. So, and I said to later on we'll do a still life day where I'll do a long still life on the stream, and I'll talk for a little bit, and then we'll get like some music going and just listen in, and just if you're joining me that day, we'll figure out what day it'll be. We'll just sit there and draw for a while, like a 2 hour, 3 hour study maybe. Just 3 hours of nonstop study stream. Maybe we'll make more of an event out of that one. Just block out 3 hours of your day. Just sit down and work alongside some other people for 3 hours. 3 hours is a pretty decent time. At at UT when I went there, our studio classes are in 4 hour sessions, and they're generally broken up into two halves. You have like a 10 to 15 minute break, and then you go to, like, people go get coffee or get water, quickly grab lunch sometimes. Well, you don't really grab lunch. You don't have time for that. Unless you brought your lunch. But that block of time of 4 hours is kind of like a good rule of for different people. I guess it matters. It takes different time periods, but for me, 3 hour block is a good, like, chunk of work time. But generally, I do like an hour of work or 2 hours, and then I'll stop, take a quick break, and then keep going. A quick break will be like I'll make coffee or something. It won't be like a go off and do something break. It'll be like a stop to make coffee or go get some water if I ran out, just to get up from the desk. But later on, I'll be sketching some. I think tonight I'm gonna explore some ideas for a Black Wolf, or sorry, not Black Wolf, but the movie's called Wizards, a fan illustration, fan art for Wizards. It's a movie about magic versus science. It's an animated movie. There's two wizards. That's why it's called Wizards. They're brothers, and the bad guy is called Black Wolf, and he embraces science over magic and the fairyland, and then the other wizard, can't think of his name. He's the magical, he's a good guy, and he embraces the magic world. And basically, in the movie, the bad guy, Black Wolf, he finds propaganda videos from the Nazi war era, and he starts using them as a way to build up an like a vicious army for the generals from hell and everything. Anyway, so I'm gonna try and do a fan art piece of him, and maybe do some of the other characters later too. And I was gonna do, like, before I decided to focus on illustration, I was gonna do like character redesigns, but I don't know if I really want to do that anymore so much as just show a scene with the character now, which, it'd be more of an illustration thing to do. I want to show the character kind of like in a setting doing something versus just like a redesigned character. If you haven't seen that movie, you should check it out. It's really cool. It's an animated movie. Some people probably seen the cover. If you remember going to the video store, it was in the fantasy sci-fi section, and it was always like it was like this red dude with a gun on a weird creature, kind of just looking at you on top of a hill. And then it just said Wizards. And it was just like, whoa, what's this about? So, anyway. It was cool. I liked it. I watched it in high school, and then I kind of like became like this movie I really liked. It's really different. It's really weird too. It kind of goes everywhere as far as like what's going on in the film. It's not like your traditional story structure. It kind of sidetracks to show like characters that have nothing to do with the plot every so often, and then like it just kind of stay with them for a bit, and it doesn't really explain itself in that regard. Yeah, so one thing I just realized I've been doing is that I've been working in grayscale, and I should be picking out colors that match the actual still life. So I need to do that in a second. Which means I kind of had to go back over everything, but not entirely. Anyway. Yeah, but I'm listening to that Crimson Conversations today with that Kemp Remillard. I've re-listened to a few of them, but this one I haven't re-listened to. It's a 4 hour long conversation with him. It was like 4.5 hours. It's just like they just stayed on that stream with him for a long while, and it's a really cool one. I forgot how cool that one was. Just I barely started it out, so he's telling a story about how he got started. It's interesting because he skips over like I've only been doing this for about it'll be my second year now. But when you start out, like that, it seems like a big deal now, like this first few years. But once you really start going, they're important, but they're not as important as like all the stuff you're doing later. So like think about whatever pieces you're struggling with now, and like the pieces you're struggling with now, and how much time you're focused on that, and then, years from now when you're actually working on like a major project of your own, or like client work that's like needs to get done, or if it's like you've made it working on like huge movies or video games, you're gonna look back on the little project you're focused on now and be like, this is like nothing. It's like a little thing that I'm doing. Like me doing these wizards, the wizards illustrations I want to do, like me making those for fun, and me thinking about, oh, I'm gonna plan that piece out. It's like, in the scope of my life, like it's just not that big a deal. Because he's in the interview, he talks about going to the massive black workshop in 2004 in Austin, which I was still in college at the time. I had no idea about concept art when that was going on. And if I had known, I totally would have gone, but I think it happened right during South by Southwest. But I don't know what I did. 2004, it was like I was just in a whole nother world at that moment. Like I wasn't even thinking about concept art. It's like a career thing, or like illustration is a career thing. But anyway, yeah, I am still in college. No, I wasn't still in college. 2004. I was in high school. What the hell I'm talking about? I got my years all mixed up. Nah, there's no way I was thinking about illustration as a career. I was gonna be a filmmaker, so I wanted to do originally. Yeah, I was in high school, 2004. Sorry, people, got my years mixed up. Excuse me. Yeah, I was in high school. I was thinking about haunted houses. That's what I used to do. That was all I was focused on. Haunted houses. Some gray tone in here. I guess not gray tone, but oh, so yeah. What was I saying? The interview is cool because he starts off talking about how he went to this workshop in Austin, 2004, when I was still in high school, and then he skips over a year of his progress and says, like, he went to the high school. He went to high school. Oh my God, I'm getting it mixed up because I'm trying to talk and draw at the same time. He says he went to the workshop 2004, and then he met people that he knew from online, which everyone who's been to one understands what that's like now. And I heard that interview before, and I didn't really think anything of it. I'm like, oh yeah, you get to meet people you met online, like, cool or whatever, you know, like. But like, it's like an understatement, you know. It's like everyone from online, or not everyone, but like lots of people from online are there. But anyway, so he says he got a portfolio review, and it was clear that he wasn't good enough to like get a job at that time, and like he had to get better. So then he says, so then he reworked his whole portfolio, and the next year he went to San Francisco. I'm like, so it was like, if you really think about it, he just skips over a year of his development, because that was just him getting better, getting good enough to start working. And you know, at the time, I'm sure that when that year he was working on his portfolio to get better, it was like a serious push versus the interview where he's talking about it, just like, yeah, it got better over that next year and I went to San Francisco. The first San Francisco one. And it's just funny that it's such a quick, like, oh yeah, I had to get better. So anyone that's like thinking about that and that mindset right now, if this is that year you had to get X thing done in your career, just remember, like, in the future it's gonna be like, yeah, so I took a year to just be not bad at what I do. This is lighter. This one's lighter. This value. Anyway, oh, and that long, when we get through and, oh, this has got some kind of variable, the color. Looks like it's got a variable going on with the color. Something's going on here. It looks like it's like blending my color choice. Maybe not. Hold on, let me check this real quick. Yeah, color dynamics is activated. Huh, interesting. Interesting. Just noticed something was going on as I was painting this wall, and I was like, it looks like the color keeps changing. There's a slight color variation. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh, so we'll do the long study. Well, maybe I'll do like a little event, like a people can invite people, but it's like a 3 hour, we'll do a 3 hour study, a life study. And just we'll start off talking a bit, but either we'll go into some music and just have like a 3 hour session, where everyone kind of gets online and does like a little 3 hour study, anyone that wants to. And then or we'll actually, what I'll do is I'll pull in somebody onto Skype, and we'll actually talk while we're doing the study. Because it, I mean, at 3 hours, at that point it's like you're gonna kind of lose what's like, what to talk, you don't know what to talk about at a certain point, because you're just drawing a still life. So you're just gonna be like, well, I'm just drawing my still life that you can't see, so it's not gonna really relate to what you're doing, because I can't see what you're doing. And I think that you're getting it correct. People are gonna be like, you have to trust what everyone else is doing to trust what everyone else is doing. Like, I could be completely off on my drawing right now, and no one would know. Okay, there we go. So, anyway, we'll pull someone else into the conversation, and maybe we'll talk about stuff. Maybe like a talk about like things to check out, like videos and resources, or just whatever, really, movies, something. So there'll be a conversation going on while we do this study, which would be a good thing to have. So I'll either pull CJ in or someone else. I don't know who. Whoever wants to talk, and it's not like annoying. Whoever wants to talk, and it's not annoying. I don't know what we're gonna do with that. I have a bunch of stuff I gotta do. This week now. And a meeting tomorrow. There's this little area of contention I just put myself in. Someone said, hey man, I don't see who you are. BobX7. Hello, BobX7. Hello. There's a darker value here. But it's not that dark. So yeah, we'll do the long still life later on. We'll make a little group about it. 3-hour still life study session, and everyone can just, you know, we should talk about music. That's what we should talk about. We should talk about what kind of music they're listening to. That way other people could figure out some new musicians, find out some new musicians, and like, they can kind of, if they don't learn anything from their study, they can walk away with a better playlist. Because I think all of us have some really particular musical tastes that the rest of us don't share, or vice versa, like musical tastes that might have like a band out of nowhere that I would never consider to listen to. What it reminded me of is that I used to do studio classes, so we would just sit there, and there would be some days where the entire day was just still life, like a 4-hour still life. Excuse me. And it was, I mean, it was cool. It was kind of BS in a way, because like the professor didn't really come over and like talk to us about it. He just played music, and we just drew for 3 hours, which, I mean, that's nice, but I could have just drawn for 3 or 4 hours. I'd prefer like having a instructor actually like talk through it or like follow along with us, and he didn't do that, so that's why it's kind of like, but the nice thing was that you're just in a group room with a bunch of people, and all y'all were drawing, and you were all just kind of stuck there doing that, so we'd all bring in our iPods or our MP3 players, whatever we had, and different days, different people would play their music. And it was just interesting to hear different people's tastes in music. He didn't like us to bring our own headphones in, which was stupid, because, if we like to listen to a certain type of music, we should be able to listen to it. Instead of having to listen to bad music the whole time. Anyway, I grew up being really particular about types of music I listen to. Used to be like a scene kid, hardcore scene in Texas. So I used to like listen to certain bands I don't really listen to anymore. I still listen to them every now and then, but the music's just so loud. I'm just not in the mood to listen to it sometimes. And everyone, they're just so pissed off, it seems. They say they're not. They say it's not angry music, but that's just bullshit. It's so angry. I'm talking about like hardcore music, not like hardcore metal or something. Hardcore metal to me isn't that hardcore. It's just like, it's hardcore in the way like pro wrestling's hardcore. Like, it's kind of entertaining and fun. But like, I listen to stuff that verges on, it literally just verged on noise. Just a bunch of people just thrashing their guitars and like making a bunch of noise. At least like metal, it's always like they have a melody and like they have a melody going on and like an actual, you know, chords, and they actually sing, not just yelling. the hardcore stuff, it was like there's bands that they called it like screamo, like emo, but they screamed. Where they would literally just be like, just they weren't singing at all. They just weren't singing. I liked the way it sounded, but they weren't singing. They like to say that the guy was a lead singer was like, he was just really good at yelling and screaming. But yeah, so some of those bands that I think they're all gone now. They're all local too, so like no one's heard of them because they broke up when I was still like in high school, and now it's been so long. It's like it's just interesting. I should look up who they were, like who was in them, and actually figure out what they're doing now. But I don't care as much anymore. I used to care a lot about finding good music, and now I don't. Now I rarely look for good music. I only reason I find good music now is through, if I'm just somewhere and I hear a cool song, I'll soundhound it, or what do they call it, Shazam it on that on your phone, and just be like, oh, what's that? And just it sounds like a cool song. And then my girlfriend has a friend that's really into like music, and she'll give mixtapes to my girlfriend, and they generally have really good stuff on them. So that's another way to find out about cool musicians. Or live streams. Whenever I hear people's live streams, I'm sure everyone's had that experience where they're on the live stream and they hear this really awesome band, and then it's like, who is that? And then the person streaming just never answers. I need to start doing that. I need to start like telling people like who I'm playing on the stream whenever I do my outros and intros, and like if I'm playing music while I'm drawing, I'll probably announce it. That way I can at least pay some respect to the artists who I'm listening to over. Like I know you can't really live stream music like that. It's not. I say you can, but you're not supposed to live stream. You're not supposed to broadcast like someone else's music. Part of like their it's like playing a movie for free. Like you can't just go somewhere and project a movie. Whether you think it's okay or not okay is irrelevant. It's just like legally you're not supposed to be able to do it. I mean, you do it anyway, but you're not supposed to. Interesting bands that I have picked up from live stream. I am, am I, who am I? That's one of the bands I like now. Actually, I heard about them back before their album came out, and they were doing a really cool like viral campaign before their first album came out, and they were posting these really cryptic videos, and the YouTube channel was called I Am I Who Am I, and so people were like trying to guess who this mysterious artist was, and you could kind of tell there was some blonde singer involved with the band, and that was it. And the music sounded really different, kind of electronic, kind of poppy, but people thought it was Lady Gaga. They thought like they just didn't know who it was. And then I remember seeing those videos back when no one really knew who they were right away, and then I just kind of didn't think anything of it and didn't disregarded after that. Like, okay, well, that was interesting. But I think it was on Dave Raposa's stream. I heard that music and I was like, what is this song? And then when I looked it up, it was I Am, Am I, Who Am I? And then I think James Zapata's played it now, but I picked it up from live stream. That was one of the. I heard it on Dave's stream. And I just took out my phone. I just took out my phone and then put it up to the speakers and was like trying to figure out who it was. And then I looked into it. I was like, oh, it's that same band, the ones that were doing the YouTube videos. And I mean, since then they've had a couple albums out. Trying to think of who else I've picked up from. That's it really, actually. That's the only band I picked up from live stream. So much for that conversation. I've only picked up one band from live stream, and it's I Am, Am I, Who Am I? Oh wait, no, there was another one. There was a Some other band. I just don't know. I'll say it in a bit. I can't think of the name right now. I'll tell you what it was. Here, let me just look it up. Now that I'm saying it, I'm gonna. Kindness. I heard Kindness. And then there's this song called House. That's it's the one I like. They do more than just that, but that one song I like a lot. I can play it right now. Let me just. I'll play it for a little bit while I'm talking. Hopefully it won't blow out anyone's ears. Oops, that's Radiohead. Don't listen. That's not. I mean, you can listen. That's not. This song right here. It's House by Kindness. I picked up this one from Livestream too. And I did the same thing. I just kabammed, or like, I sound hounded the speakers of my computer.
Enough to say you're getting old every day you are someone. You break down and you pray, hoping something comes your way. You are someone, love someone.
Yes, I am. Can people hear me? Can people not hear me? Am I talking to people? Hold on, let me stop the music. Okay. I'm talking to people in the chat, yeah. I'm not talking to anyone. I'm not talking to anyone like on Skype, if you think I'm... there's like a whole half of a conversation you don't think you hear. I'm just arbitrarily talking. I didn't think about that. Yeah, I'm not talking to anyone on Skype right now. Everyone's just like, what? Who's he talking to? Is he just talking to, like, some guy about music or some other person? No, I'm just arbitrarily talking to the chat because for these studies, I try to keep running dialogue so that if you watch the video later, you can kind of feel like you're doing the study with a person. So, yeah, I'm just trying to just recreate the feeling that you're, like, working with someone on a study, like you're both working on something together, and like you're sitting next to them, even though, I mean, you know, you're not. Like, you're not sitting next to me, because that's weird, because then you'd be breaking into the house. But yeah, so this band is called Kindness, and the song's called House. So I'll play it real quick for a little bit, and then I'll probably play some other music, and I'll tell you guys about the bands too. Only because right now I'm doing a still life, and it's so hard to, like, y'all can't see what I'm drawing, and I can see it, you can't, and I'm just gonna talk about music while that happens. Yeah, this is a Kindness House.
And you pray, hoping something comes your way. You want to love someone, love someone.
So yeah, that was House by Kindness. You can pick up that album today at the local record store. Anyway, I don't sound like a DJ. But I guess I'll go through it real quick while I'm doing this. Some of the other music I play on my stream, at least. But yeah, I picked up them from Kindness and... yeah, what is this? Kindness and I Am, Am I, Who Am I? I picked up from Dave Repose's live stream. And... there's some music on Dan Warren's live stream that I really like. I can't think of, I have no idea what it's, who it is, and, but it's like these remixes of songs that are like mashed together, but I need to figure out what they were, but they're like these remix songs, and it's like different songs and some audio clips like mashed together, and it's all played as a song. I've been really enjoying those whenever I hear it. I need to go, what I need to do is I need to go onto a stream and then play one of the videos where he has that music and do the sound hound and just pick it up that way. Everyone else, people like to ask, like, they ask the artist to tell them what the music is. And, I'm always ready to say it, but also I'm in the middle of drawing sometimes, so I don't want to stop just to go over and be like, it's Radiohead or something. But some of the music I play in my stream is some of my favorite musicians. So I love the Mars Volta. It's a band that they're no longer together, but I love the Mars Volta and the members of the Mars Volta, their music. It's really cool. I'll play a song from the Mars Volta real quick so y'all understand what that sounds like. But the Mars Volta is my favorite band. So that, like, if you get an idea of what kind of music I like from hearing this band. Let me get this mixer up. I don't want it to be too loud. There's some songs that everyone knows. But I'll play... play Concertina. No, that's the wrong album. Where is it? It's not even on here. The EP album. I'll have to play well, that's a popular song. I'll play a song that I really like. Luciforms? Copernicus? I think it's Copernicus. Thank you. If you like this song, then you like the Mars Volta, because this is not one of their popular songs. I love everything they do, so I'm like that guy that they could do the Hokey Pokey, and I'll be like, oh my god, have you heard their rendition of the Hokey Pokey? So, click on that YouTube link in a little bit. What's your name? Super Spartan. So anyway, that band broke up though, so they don't... not together anymore. But the guitarist that wrote all the music for everything, like he wrote all the parts himself, he has his own music, and that stuff sounds, it's very similar obviously, but it's a little different still. This is Omar Rodriguez Lopez. Thank you. Oops.
Squarespace provides everything you need to create an exceptional website for you or your business.
Oh, I don't
want to
hear that commercial. Okay, so, anyway, it's the other band. I guess I'll let that commercial play real quick. I don't know if you can hear that or not, but let the commercial play through, because I'm not paying for the upgrade to Spotify right now. Okay, so, quick history. So that band, that's the guitarist and main musician from the Mars Volta. That's his own personal music. And you might know the singer and the guitarist from the Mars Volta from their original band, At the Drive-In, which everyone seems to know. If you're into this kind of music, you know this band, but this is their popular song, so I'll play this real quick.
Yes, this is the campaign slithered in jails in the cargo bay. A new turd is the vastness, hollow vacuum, chop the oxygen tanks. Hibernate, but have they kissed the ground? Pucker up and kiss the asphalt now. Tease this amputation, splinter of larynx, it has access now.
So that's their old band they used to be in. They're from El Paso, Texas, originally. But all their new stuff sounds completely different, or at least you liked it. Which one are you talking about? Their new stuff. Okay, so like the guitarist from the Mars Volta, and he was the guitarist for the At the Drive-In, but he was the main musician for the Mars Volta. I pretty much listen to like everything he does and his bandmates do. I listen to all their music. That's kind of how I find my music. So it's very much cut off. Oh, Laserhawk. Laserhawk is someone I discovered through live streams. Bosnian Rainbows is the newest band that, it's the lead singer from Le Butcherettes, and, Dantony Parks, and Omar Rodriguez Lopez, and a keyboard player who I don't know. This is their popular song right now, though. The song was One Armed Scissor by At the Drive-In. This one's Torn Maps by Bosnian Rainbows. Okay, so. Ah, crap. There we go. Oh, and the other song was, I don't think I said the other one. There was a song by Omar Rodriguez Lopez I played. That's, it's called Home Lost by Omar Rodriguez Lopez. Home Lost. That's this one. anyway, that's some of the music I always put on here. If you haven't heard of the band, there's a band called Alt J. It's really cool. They've got this song. It's really. Oops. My timer. I'm going to keep going for a little bit longer, but here's Alt J, Breeze Blocks.
You may contain the urge to run away, but hold her down with soggy clothes and breeze blocks. Cedrazine, your fevers greet me again. Never kisses, or do you ever send our full stop? Do you know where the muffins go? They go along to take your honey. Way down how we build our breakfast down and say, my love, my love. Pistol shows, hold her down with soggy clothes and breeze blows. She's morphine, queen of my vaccine, my love, my love, love, love. La 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 la, muscle to muscle and toe to toe. Soggy clothes and breeze blocks. Germaline, disinfect the scene. My love, love, love. Please don't go. I don't know. My lovely.
Blocks. I'm going to finish this up and get on to some work now. But thanks for joining me. And I said it before, I'll say it again. Next 7 days for me I'm going to focus on anatomy. And I'm going to be kind of pulling from, like, medical... There's specific things I'm trying to study, and that's, like, the muscle groups and how the muscles work. So that when I need to, I could pose my characters without having to take a picture of myself. I mean, I'll still do that, but I'd rather have the picture of myself be for lighting reference as opposed to for muscle posture. So these next 7 days, I'm going to probably focus everything on anatomy. So whoever wants to join in for 7 days of anatomy stuff, feel free to join in on the stream or follow along on CJ's or whatever. Doesn't really matter which one. But we all have different focuses. So if you're going to want to study anatomy, if you're in that area right now yourself, I'll be doing 7 days of anatomy studies, an hour each. And what I'm going to focus on is, like, how the muscles work, how they attach together, how they move together, and how they look in certain positions. And I'll try and create my own poses based after the knowledge I've learned. But I'm probably going to break it up like a... The way it'll work will be, I'm going to break each day up by the area of the body. So, the first few days are probably going to be the arms, specifically arms, and then we'll go into legs. We'll jump around just a little bit, but arms and legs will be the first couple, and I'll focus on the core. And then we'll start getting a little nitty-gritty with, like, specifically hands, specifically feet, specifically the face and, like, the muscles of the face and how those interact and create expressions. And what else? Hands, legs, feet, chest, torso. Chest and torso, of course. And then, like, there's a day I really want to spend on, I really want to spend, like, an hour or so on just drawing the connective areas, like the areas where the arms connect to the torso, you know, where the legs connect to the crotch area. And those are those kind of nitty-gritty areas that lots of artists don't ever... Normally the poses for those characters aren't... You know, your characters never pose in such a way where you need to, like, show his armpit. Sometimes if he has, like, an axe over his head or something. But, like, those little areas, I want to get a grasp on those for sure. A better grasp on what I've got. Right now when I do reference, I use my reference for both the lighting and anatomy, like positioning of the arms and legs. But if I can really ease up on using reference for anatomy and only have to use it for lighting, it would be a really nice progression to make where I could just focus on that for a little bit. But so yeah, we'll do 7 days of anatomy studies, and you know, ideally you go apply it back into your projects yourself, but it'll help. The goal would be that once we're done, once we're done with the 7 days, people will have a better grasp on posing their characters. Okay, that's all I'm going to do for today. Let me read the chat real quick. Is there a good place to learn to paint with digital media? Yes. There's a... How new are you? CJ Marsh, me and Miguel are doing the study group. The best really, really do is to study. There's more chat. Crimson Daggers threads. Plenty of tutorials. Yes. Crimson Daggers, plenty of tutorials. Let me do the thing where I just put out my... I just gotta put my name on this. like a kid in school. Daily study. Bear with me for a second and I'll quickly go through some resources. What is today? Five? I don't know what today is. I'll just put still life. Still life. So, let me turn off speaker audio. Can you hear me? Yeah, I guess you'll hear me. Okay. I'll run through everything for you real quick. That's fine. When does the anatomy study start? Yeah, so this forum has a thread. Crimson Daggers. CJ and I are part of the Crimson Daggers forum, part of the Crimson Daggers study group. I'm going to run through some quick resources for you. Just because, crap. Just because I might as well. Go to the Crimson Daggers forum. If you want to find out more information about the study group, go to the Crimson Daggers forum. Go to the partner/group dailies section. You click on that. It's going to bring you into the forum. And it actually, if you look, there's a ton of other groups in here. Like, it's not just CJ and I. But I think with the method we're doing, I think we're some of the only people that are actively streaming a day right now. I don't know for sure, but we are the Daily Study Group, and that's my username, Mike086. If you click on the Daily Study Group thread, you will see everything you want to read about. It tells you the structure, it tells you where, when, how, and it doesn't tell you how, but save as. Let me just, actually, I'll post this right now while I'm on the forum, but, Christ almighty, okay, here we go. Today's the 7th-14. JPEG. Okay, so, I gotta do this thing because I just realized what I did. I'm gonna crop it in a bit. Bear with me, people. I'll go over some resources as soon as I post this. But I'm gonna make y'all watch. Save. There we go. Oh, Christ. Okay, close, don't save, close, don't save. Here we go. So if you go to this thread, it has the links to all the different streams, at least there's two streams. It's got a link to the Daily Lesson Plans document, and if you go to that document, you'll see our schedule. But you'll also note that right now, the 7 days we're doing so far have been just me throwing stuff out as far as like what I think we should do. But after doing some personal work, some drawings, I really want to focus on anatomy for a little bit. So, the next 7 days will be, for me, anatomy, all about anatomy. If you don't catch these videos live, I'm putting them up on YouTube. And I'm putting them up on, they're on the archive, so you can go through the look. You can look through the old ones on this one. You can look through the old ones right here in my archive, I guess we're on day five. But it's basically the idea would be you go back in my stream or CJ's stream, any one of us, really. There's other people doing it. I think Marjorie's doing it on live stream also. But you can go back through Marjorie Davis is her name. You go back through our videos and you can follow along with us as if we were doing them with you live. And that's kind of the idea of why we're live streaming them. Sorry. Right now, one of my focus is to work for Wizards of the Coast, so I've got a bunch of Wizards of the Coast stuff up. Okay, let's see, here we go. The video from yesterday and today's study. So, but there's also some other resources videos, and I've actually got a video in my YouTube channel that I list off all my online resources, and I kind of made that video for just such an occasion, where like, I made the video that I wish I would have found when I started out. That's what I did. So, I'll link you to that in a second. My YouTube channel is youtube.com/Mike086. I believe I think that's how you get to the channel. But my username is Mike086, so if you don't know what to do, just search my username on YouTube. But there's a video where I just go through every single resources and I kind of talk about all of them and like how they've helped me. This is a way for me to plug myself, really, guys. But I'll show you. But no, I seriously did make this video for like this. OS X version. This looks really good, though. Nemo. I have a Mac, just reformatted. It's a pretty good free painting program out there. Krita. I think you can also do GIMP. Namo. GIMP. And also Namo. Photoshop CS2 is offered free online right now. You can download it for free. So if you want a really old version of Photoshop, you can go Photoshop CS2 and you can download it. I'm gonna link a video to y'all. It's called My Online Resources. And I close it before it starts. There we go, okay. It's this video. You don't mind using Photoshop, yeah. CJ. I mean, before I bought Photoshop, I just pirated it in my own. I had, like, CS3 for the longest time. And then I pirated CS4. And, I had both of those for the longest time. But, now, I mean, I bought it for real. I legitimately bought it, a while back. So I've actually got the production premium. So I got like After Effects, and because I used to work a lot more in film stuff, I still do, but right now my focus is my illustration. But anyway, cloud thing is kind of cool. There's some ups and downs about it, but CS6, yeah. That YouTube video is just my resources that I just go through the different websites and show y'all what's going on. There's a ton of websites on how to use Photoshop, like how to actually use the setups and get your stuff going. That's excuse me. That stuff's easy to find. The hard stuff to find is once you actually know how to draw and paint in Photoshop. The hard stuff to find is like the composition. Anything on composition is a little hard for me to find. And but you can get feedback and critiques easily. Where's this? There's another video. I'm going to show you this real quick too. But I did this video also. So this is another plug for myself. But if you're wondering where these videos are, they're on YouTube. My username, Mike086. But I did a digital painting in Photoshop quick start tutorial. And this is the video I wish I had when I started digital painting. I go through the basics of using Photoshop for illustration. That's all it is. So, anyway. I'll link that to you too. It's really basic. It's like super... It's super basic. Like, I don't draw anything in it. All I do is talk about settings. And there's a good one that FZD School does. They're on YouTube also. And if you watch the resources video, you'll also pick up FZD School. I talk about that on the resources video. But they have a video where they talk about how to use Photoshop and settings and all the technical stuff. I go through real quick on mine. I try and go through the very, very basics to get you started doodling, basically. I don't go through any of the other stuff. FZD School goes through a lot more things, and in terms of like Photoshop knowledge, after going to the workshop in LA, like I feel like I know next to nothing compared to the concept art guys that they're exploring the program and actually doing new things with it that I didn't think were possible. Anyway. Cool. So, that's everything. And like I said before in my past video, I like to make this a production, so I'm going to put on some outro music for everybody. And, you can listen to some outro music by let's do I Am, Am I, Who Am I. I talked about them earlier. Here we go. Blow your ears out. Sorry about that. This is Kill by I Am, Am I, Who Am I.